And in anything you do, you must know where you're going and how you're going to get there. It doesn't matter what business you're in. That's most important. You must have a plan of action and an objective. And if you're going to achieve that plan, you have to follow those objectives clearly to reach, to get the results you want. You can't start a brand from scratch. And because we were a commodity producer, only producing commodity spirits for exports to Canada and the UK. And we decided about 12, 15 years ago that we had to change this. We had to get into brands, because the brands is where you make your margins. And the first thing we did was to decide what the bottle would like to look like. I don't know if those of you who have been to Guyana, you have a bottle store that sells old Dutch bottles. We collected a dozen of those bottles, brought in a designer from the UK, and said to him, look, see one of these bottles, this one, particular one here? This is what we want. Because it was my managing director and myself. We sat down with a guy, and we told him the contour we wanted. Same, but with some differences. And that was duly done after the second, third try. So the bottle is our El Dorado 15, which has a reputation that is second to none. I would say that with justification. 10 gold medals in the last few years from the International Wine and Spirit Competition, rated by the Institute of Tasting in Chicago as one of the best, or the best. And I say no more. Plus, one of our rums, our El Dorado 21, has been rated 97 points, highest for any spirit. So yes, we've come a long way. Coming back to the bottle, that's the first thing. Design, agree the bottle, then the packaging, then the label, the cap, and everything. I wanted to know how could I produce a product and try to sell it as the same as a bottle of Johnny Walker Scotch. I explained to him what we're producing here is something unique. It's classic. It could compare with the best cognac in the world. And I mean that. I've been able to prove that. And even the some of the Scotch whiskies. And they're distinct, different products. But ours, our El Dorado, especially 15, is very distinctive. Remember that CARICOM is a small grouping of 5 million people. Whatever you produce, you're producing for the market. And in producing for the market, you have to have certain basic concepts in mind and carry those out. And that includes you must produce a product that is distinctive, because you can't sell your product only in CARICOM or CSME. You have to sell it globally. This market is very, very small. And we decided to look at the global market and what we wanted to do. Of course, to do all of that involves spending money, which we didn't always have, but the little we had to spread it around. And today we are selling in all over Europe, the UK, of course, including the Soviet Union, the Caribbean, and one of our best markets recently has turned out to be Canada. It was impossible to get on the liquor boards because they have a control mechanism that is rigid. Finally, we were able to get there, and last year, we had a growth rate in Canada of 66%. To be successful, your plan has to be on target in the sense that the markets must be targeted. You must produce a product that is distinctive, that is well packaged. Packaging is critical for any product you sell in the global market. And we consider our products to be unique in many sense. They're packages, the packaging that we do for our products are as good as anything you get in the first world. And you must produce that product and be able to deliver when and where it's wanted. If you can't do that and you can't supply, well, you better well get out of the market. Manufacturing is very challenging, but you need also funds to manufacture goods and services. And that means that you must sustain your business, always replace and renew your assets on a timely basis, otherwise you won't stay in business long. If you don't replace and modernize your plant and equipment, then you are in trouble. It's only a matter of time. So if those of you who are in manufacturing, keep that in mind, you will never go wrong.